don't know if that part was cut, but whatever. I used to play this game, and when I used to play this game, I used to play this team, Robo-Fortune, Philia, Big Band. I should actually save it to recognition. There we are. So I used to play this team a lot, and I think I played it for, I want to say it's like 7 to 8 months or something like that. At least some variations of this anyway. There are 3 major variations to think about when you're picking this team up, but whatever. So I was playing this team for the better half of whenever I was playing this game, competitively or not, whatever. When I was trying to learn this game, I was playing this team, and whenever, like, when Robo came out, I started playing it. I think it's a really, really, really solid team that actually has more variations than most other teams in Skullgirls. And, like, I just had some, I had, like, a set of notes that you can't really see. I don't know why I'm holding this up right now. I had some, like, sets of notes that you could, like, what things you could do with this team and different assists and stuff like that. And I was looking through my stuff and I realized I couldn't find it, so I was scared. So when I found it, I realized I should probably just put this up anyway, because at one point I had a huge idea of making like a how to play team whatever whatever. I was gonna call this team YOMA, but it was gonna be stupid anyway. Who cares? I was gonna make that, but then when I had this thing where I couldn't find my notes, I was like, I should probably put this up right now anyway, because I'm not gonna have the time, or really the willingness, to put a lot of time into making a video as polished as, you know, like the Marvel 2 How to Play Team Mike Z or How to Play Team Combo Fiend, stuff like that. The videos for that are out there. Just to make sure. Yeah, it's working. Everything's fine. I should probably put some music in the background. Extremely faint, so I don't get copyrighted or whatever over it. Not that it matters to me. So this is basically like me just talking about the notes that I had and like the theories, things that I had, whatever. So first of all, I called it team Combo Fiend in Red Q, because I have Iron Man, I have Magneto, which is part of Team Combo Fiend, and I have Red Q, because red is a fun color, and I also had like robots in anime, because I think I had like, I should actually just go through the colors, because colors are super super important to manage properly. I think I had like Terminator, which means that one. No, it's still that one. No, that's far off. Terminator, and I had whatever this color is from some anime. I don't remember. And I had RoboCop, a Big Band. There was that. I had some other colors. I couldn't remember them. I think I had like Cable, not Cable, a Spiral, Magneto, something that kind of looked like Sentinel, so it just didn't work out. But this team doesn't really have good Marvel 2 colors. I mean, outside of the Red Q thing. The Combo Fiend Red Q. I'll just pick that. I don't know. I'll pick the robots and anime colors, because why the hell not? Anime is cool, and robots are cool. Before I go into anything, I should note, these assists are not the only assists you can, and this order is not the only order you can pick with this team. Alternative orders you can pick with this team are Philia Point with either Hairball Assist or Dash Assist. I'll pick Hairball, because Hairball is easier to show stuff with. And I think it was this color. No. I forgot what the color was supposed to be. And I could pick with Philia, I could pick either that, or I could pick Dash, Theonite Beam, Beat Extend, or I could also pick Dash, Standing Heart Punch for Robo, and Heavy Brass for Big Band. The latter two are more suited to Philia Rushdown. It's the last one is like a Wolverine team from Marvel. It's designed to just get in and just get things done and just kill you. So that's kind of the point of that team. The team with just Dash is a lot more, like, I can afford to stay back a little bit more. I'll get into it once I talk about, like, actual team theory. I'll just click this. I think it's just me going, yeah. There we go. So what do my notes say? It says, a very versatile team with lots of options for different matchups and a lot of room for depth and different strategies. I agree with that, it said that. The three main orders were Robo-Fortune, Philia, Big Man, H-Beam, H-Airball, LX-10, yeah, Philia, da-da-da. The Dash, Denny Hardpunch, H-Brass is useful versus Peacock teams. Teams with H-Air, H-Brass is the easy counter assist to create from range, and Denny Hardpunch is an easy counter pick. Counter assist up close, less flexible, but this is primarily a Philia-based team, is not structured to be as well-rounded. Ultra Rushdown, yeah. That's a good card, it is. Elta has some neat coordinated colors, yeah. Which is also true, I just showed that. Robo-Fortune, I had to say state, main point character for this team. This structure does well against most of the common points in the game, and when played perfectly, is very difficult to open up due to Arbiter's mobility and zoning tools. Also, Philia and Big Ben assist give RF zoning tools more credence by letting her convert them to damage, which is also true. I don't know what I'm thinking. Okay, so the first conversion I want to show is Ground Throw into Big Ben. This is not what I wanted. It's stuff like that. This is universal. It works in every single character in the game. And like I showed you, you can throw them towards, but they can you can do that and like run on the other side and do that. Or if you're smart, you will not do that. You will just properly throw them on whatever side you want and save OTG. Like. Like that, useful for is that sort of stuff, and then you can do that. Ground throw combo using Philia, very difficult character specific, go for BB whenever possible. I remember where I wrote this because. One, it's really hard to just dash up and do it. Because the dash timing is really tricky. I'm gonna fail terribly at this because that's kind of the point. I think this is easier to whiff. Oh, I don't have to bring it out because I'm down. Never mind. Don't worry about it. You can just like not do anything in this from the okay. I'm gonna try and land it, I swear. Yeah, because sometimes that will happen. That's why it's inconsistent. That's why I wrote that. I remember. This is like 8 months old, I believe. It's like stupid old. So I don't remember what most of the why I wrote most of the stuff I wrote. And I swear you can do this. It's hard, but you can do this. Jesus Christ. I'm not that bad. It sucks when that happens. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. This is just awful. I look terrible right now. There you go! And I dropped the combo. It works. Trust me, it works. It's again, like I said, it's very difficult, character specific to some extent, because sometimes some characters will fall out the hairball more than others, and especially during happy birthday situations, which like it's hard to set up that way. But like if you have like some way some other character showing up or whatever, it's just not gonna work. So don't bother with it. Happy birthday corner push for using Philia works in 70% of the screen. Let's show that again. I'm probably gonna drop it all the time because I'm dumb like that. I haven't practiced this team in literally months. Oh, I think it should work past here. Let's have them actually before I do anything. Gold. What the hell? Oh, there we go. Medium material is fine. This is some fantastic music. Kappa. Where is the thing I need? There we go. I'm getting through these relatively fast. There's a good assist for that, because one, screw Bella, and two, this assist is good for that, because it's not invincible. Happy birthday, corner push. What did I write right for this? Happy birthday, Mithilia, blah, 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 blah. Okay, let me try that. Whoops. How to do that. You can do stuff like that. I dropped it because I'm an idiot, but you can definitely do stuff like that. It was corner carry from about this part of the screen, which is kind of sounded really good. It's a big part of it is that hairball assist. It has a ton of corner carry, and RF has a fast test, so you can run up an OTD snap. If you snap when you have full undizzy, by the way, like it doesn't really matter, you'll get the snap anyway. It's not like you can burst the snap or whatever stupid garbage, but it works out, and then you get the happy birthday, whatever. That's that. Corner, I think. Yeah, I don't think I've found anything good for, like, 100% corner carry or whatever, but like if you're closer to the corner and you don't believe in that corner, either you don't have that assist, because you might have a dash assist for Philia, which I'll explain why in a second. Happy birthday, side Twitch using Big Band. Using do okay. Okay. What did I write for this? Okay. Wrong assist. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna be amazing at this. Oh, I can just do that. How about how to do that? I mean, of course, if you're over here, then you can snap. As you can, like, literally see. Wow. I just got full bleeded. Whatever. You get the point. Like, can you show the whole combo? Sending me punch, catching me a blink. Catching a heart punch. Oh. Yeah, I forgot the combo. I forgot the button to hit. Really bad at this. And steer down, and you can snap right after that. I just want to sure to snap. Oh, you need to do that thing, yeah. You can do stuff like that. Of course, the assist dropped out, but like I've shown it plenty of times, the assist actually hits. Sorry about that. This combo is actually kind of difficult. Of course, you don't have to do it from this close away. You can actually go with save assist. You can actually do it from somewhere around here. Like that, and then you can snap. So you can do that if you want. If you found yourself in a happy birthday situation, you can do that. Of course, the confirming the BB one is a lot harder, because you have to immediately cut your combo into a completely different route, because you would never really go for clutching medium kick in your starter combo. But of course, if you can confirm it, or if you see the assist coming in, or you're like, okay, you can, you know, you can use your judgment to change whatever combo you want to do. Air being confirmed using BB. Good there. Basically, when you're running around and doing beams, not with that, but with that, if they jump into it and you call B and X in the same time, you can do that. Honestly, there's not a ton of reasons you would want to do this. Like, maybe if you're like, you're already committed to doing a beam, like, but then you see the, you see it's gonna hit, so you can, like, instead of doing the beam, you do just, like, instead of doing medium punch, you do medium punch and then hard kick together. Honestly, there's not a whole lot of point. You just go back, run back and call assist. This is a lot weaker, not necessarily not a lot weaker, but, like, a lot less useful to do, while as this let's have a jump actually. This only works on specific altitudes, but you can use Polia to confirm off a beam, and it's gonna be hard to set the needle with this. I forgot what the grim was. God damn, where is it? Did I note this anywhere? I can't find it anywhere. This is frustrating. Like that! Oh yeah, you're supposed to use HP. I'm dumb. That makes sense. Not my next decision. Then you can do that. Whatever you want, stuff, it works out. So magnet is really useful for that. If you don't want to use magnet, let me show that. Of course, this has to be like specific altitude, so you like you have to properly get the height and angle and stuff like that. I'm getting terrible at showing this. Of course, it doesn't work for super far away, but if you're close up, it would kind of work. Philly, at least cooperate, Jesus Christ. Goddamn, Philly. God fucking damn it. I want to show this at least once. Of course, you're not gonna be using H-beam that close, but goddamn, it's only 3 units. But like, if you're like over here, it kind of hits. Like, I'm gonna be trouble at threading the needle with this garbage. You just take my word for it. It works. I assured you at one point you can run up and do it. Just believe me. It doesn't. I mean, of course, it's not gonna work from like super far away because one like the assist is not gonna hit. But if it hits, you might have a lot tougher time trying to run up and convert off of it. But the benefit of doing this over something like just run up, like beat extend, is that even if it blocked the H-beam, the assist is still coming down. And you can use that assist block stun to set up more stuff, like setting out crouching hard punches, or setting, either calling hard punches or setting out the hard, the heads or whatever. Stuff like that. Actually, let's not do that anymore. It's disorientating me. But yeah, you can do stuff like that. Crouching medium kick, light beam confirmed using big band. Standard DNB. The thing with using this is that while it doesn't do a lot of damage because it immediately scales your hits or whatever, because you immediately come from off an assist, a lot of times in neutral, people will be using like armor to get through, especially if you don't have a head out, like a mine out, like that. Like, when you have a mine out, people like Bella, Big Bang can't really use rush punches if you're smart about it. But if you're not smart about it, like, I mean, if you don't have mine out, is what I'm trying to say, they might try to armor move through you, and using this as a hard read, because crouching medium kick counts as a, what do you call it, one of the things that cuts armor sweeps. It counts as a sweep, which is, like, it kind of sort of is, because, like, when an oxygen gives a blue bounce or whatever, but you can combo off of it, so you can use that, and you can, like, If you're pretty sure they're gonna do that, you can just run up and crouch a medium kick and then confirm and try to confirm off of it. If you get the confirm, it's all good. That's from BB using Philia. Crouch a medium kick confirm. Where's the combo? Oh, I just wrote it as a stage 3 pickup, huh? Okay. If you do with Philia, you can do crouching medium kick right into hairball. And fail the combo like I'm an idiot. Is that what the combo is? 2-2, okay. Okay. Ah, God, that's really, really stupid hard to land. Jump hard punch. This is you can link. I'm not gonna be very good at landing it, so just take my word for it. I'll write the state 3 confirm in the description. You can find it, you can try it. It's not particularly easy, but it's something you can try. I think there's better ones than Skullheart at this point, to be quite honest. It depends on whatever, like, what, the thing you're starting out with. Like, for some things you will have the extra 20 undizzy, for some things you won't, because, like, things are weird. Okay. I'm kind of tired, but I really want to get this done. Random full screen beam super to Gregor. Oh, yes. This doesn't work in this one anymore. It used to work when I used to play here, and when this game was popular over here. Oh, this song's so cool. Oh, whatever, what's the thing? Like, if you're full screen, he can kinda sort of throw this out! Kind of! It's not very good! It just, I mean, if you throw it out, it works out fine, great. But if it gets blocked, it's your ass. And people have gotten way the hell better at reacting to this ever since I wrote these on my, wrote this in my notes. Because it used to work at the time I used to play. It's kinda silly. Like, if you're, like, over here or whatever, someone's, like, really, really into just jumping in, you can just throw this out, because why not? And it's post-flash unblockable, so if they weren't blocking pre-flash, they get hit. Of course, you can, like, react to what the hell she's doing if you're, like, actually looking. But, if this ever hits, and you just throw this out, and it hits, you can DHQ Gregor. You can eat into Philia things. I don't know what the optimal Philia combo is there anymore. there's that, of course. That's really cool. That's something you can try. Tired right now, goddamn. I did not have a good night's sleep. Light danger confirmed. Oh yeah, light danger. When I thought this move was gonna be useful. Oh yeah, I was wrong. Light danger is I can show the hitbox just to like hitboxes and slow motion. Can you see my mouse actually? No, you can't. Let's go. I don't care. It's upper body invincible. There's no hitbox in the upper body, as you can see. It's really useful as an end here against like Fukua jump hard kick, big bend jump light kick. But if the empty jump and this gets blocked, it's kind of your ass. That's kind of a problem. Fortunately, there's a way to make this safe. Or, like, relatively safe anyway. Of course, they can push block at some point and just land anyway. It's gonna be hard as shit to land. I mean, you can do that, and you can, like... And you can just do magnet. Magnet makes a lot of these conversions super, super, super easy, so always keep that in mind. You can just do magnet. But that's a, a stage 3 conversion, so... Stage 3 combo starter, so always keep that in mind. That what options you have off of that. I am pretty sure you can. Oh, god damn. Sorry. Oh, I'm tired. Out of the shit. I really should get some coffee. I swear this works. There we go, it worked. You saw that work, and then you can like do crushing meat kick, crushing hard punch and this stuff and whatever. I don't care anymore. You can also combo this to beat extend, but the way you've set up your team currently, with light danger you can only call your second assist, not your third assist, because it's a light kick and the assist calling method is just stupid. I think I can do this with that. Like that. That makes the combo much easier because it's speed extend and he's right there. But it doesn't make it. I don't care. But it makes it much more like. The confirm is much easier, but it's also not as safe because you don't have the hairball pushing them out, whatever. What else? That's. Oh no, there's a few more. Oh, goddamn. There's a few more things that I want to show. If you're doing a combo and you end up going to crushing mini kick, like stuff like that, if you really wanted to do that, there's some interesting options you can do with Philia Assist with that. There we go. How do I show this? I'll just do like that. Like, you can run up and you can... Oh, crap. It's gonna be hard to land. He can do that. The idea is that you get the head out and then you put the kamikaze out. And by the time the kamikaze reaches them, you can already throw them. This works in both tech directions, by the way. This works in both directions, if you can learn to confirm off of it, then you can do that. And that's a really cool, like, solo assist sort of thing, where you have the... Like, if at that point they were to jump out of your throw, they'll get not hit. They'll have to block the kamikaze. It doesn't make it completely safe. After first hit, I can just make it so that it's jumping. Like that. I'll set it to always block high. This should fix it. Like that. It's not terribly. Plus, I can actually have a look. What is attack data? Advanced. Just to make sure. That's zero if they ground block it. But if they jump, it's minus nine. So, like, it's not completely safe. But it's still something you can try on occasion, especially if you get them so that they're in pre-jump frames, so they're throw invincible, but they're still on the ground, so they ground block the projectile. That's something you can set up. That it's kind of hard to set up, actually. It depends on the character, because this game is stupid like that. I mean, like, whenever I say this game is stupid, it's not like that it's, like, actually stupid, but some things in this game just trick me a lot. I mean, it's not like that's not every other fighting game as well, but, you know, whatever. Like, when you're in pre-jump, but you're grounded, the projectile will hit as if you're grounded, and the blocks then it puts on you, which I can show right now with this, is... I'm dumb. Whoa, that was fantastic. Thank you, Philia. God damn it. That made me look bad. They get 38 frames. And your throw width is 36, so you can even, like, if you time it perfectly and you space yourself perfectly, whatever, you can even make that situation plus 2. Actually, I don't know if that works. No. That won't work because you're put in pre-block by the thing, and then your throw invincible. Whatever. I am dumb. Just. It's a thing that happens, okay? It's not as good as I thought it was, which shows you how much thought I put into this, because, like, I mean, this is like 8 months old, whatever. It's a trick you can use on occasion, I suppose. Because people will be like, oh my god, there's the head coming, but then you throw them, like, whoa! It's a gimmick. It's really sort of, it's just a gimmick. Of course, you can use it to, like, set up, like, actual good mix-ups, like, run up and low, or run up and try to, like, if you see them up back, but they end up ground blocking it, you can, like, I can show it with. After first hit, I can make it always. So, like, if they try to pre-block it, they'll be stand-blocking. And if you... Oh, that's really tough to show. You can stuff like a... show, like, an instant overhead like that. Of course, that's only if they're up-backing. But if they're up-backing, you can also, like, blow them. But if they're crash-blocking, it's not gonna work as well. But then you can just run up and, like, dust them or whatever. But then if they're down backing, you can, like, also run up and throw them before the thing happens. It's a little mix of situation that you can show up. It's not particularly great. But, you know, it's a thing that can happen. What else I've written? Okay. Crutching mean kick tune for HK, CHK. If you already have a couple of heads out, this is something you can try to do if you want to set up your zoning for a little bit. I want her to not block. Damn, they kamikaze think gonna blew up in her face, huh? He can like and do that, and then you have missiles coming down, and you can set up like other zoning track tricks with it that you want to do. That's, you know, that's kind of like the floor is open to you. Try whatever you want. You got missiles coming down. You can like you already have a you have another head out. You can do other things with it that you might want to do. You might want to use that time to set up a mine, or set up a kamikaze, or run up and throw, or run up and or run back and like let your assist regenerate, or like shoot beams, whatever you want. Yeah, like that's a good setup. That's a good zoning situation for you. Another thing you can try and just do that. I mean, it's obviously terrible with like just one head. But if you have two heads, that did not go as well as I thought it would. You can also use that to set up missiles. It's not as good because you don't have as much advantage, but it helps you. If you already have like, if you only have one head out and you want to set up some zoning situations with that, you can use that, set that up. It's useful. Anything else that I've written? Oh yeah, steady hard kick into three heads. I think it's common knowledge that steady hard kick gives you two heads on hits, but with certain assists, and hairball is one of them. You can get three heads with that. It doesn't give you a whole lot of advantage, or you can use it to set up two heads and like put one down or something like that, whatever you want to do. The trick is to steady hard kick and hit the assist when the opponent hits the wall, and like that, like at about that time. If you can hear my button, I'm gonna hit it super loud for this instance, but I'm trying not to do that usually. And then's when you hit it. And you can drop it like an idiot, and that. So it's not actually like when you hit it, when they hit the wall, like it's slightly before they hit the wall, like that. And then you can get the three hits and stuff like that happens, and you can, you know, set up stunning stuff. It's cool. Other sys can do that as well, people don't look into this that much, but I think it's something cool to set up situations. What else? Oh, tags. I forgot about this. And Max and Dizzy SR combo. I forgot about that. There we go. I need hairball and I need meat extend. I need this. It kind of sucked that these notes are so old. I would have revised them way the hell, like, they actually note down what I was thinking when I was writing them down. Never. Let's have Philly a jump. And let's actually first have her at Max and Dizzy. Where's Undizzy? Drama Undizzy. There you go. Max and Dizzy. Or, I mean, this is not just like air throw, but this like ground confirmed stuff. But for air throw, I chose them more often because for air throw, you'll always use up your OTG to convert off of it. Where's the thing? I want her to be the jumping in the thing. Cool. That's not what I wanted. You can do stuff like that. Where is the thing I wanted to take that off? Let me set my button so I can show this much easier. Oh, this is a good song. Whatever, don't pay attention to that. Okay, before I go into this in a lot more detail, the concept is that you want to do one of your danger moves and call it assist after that. You want to do either medium danger into either Philia, or you want to do medium danger into Big Band. Or you want to do medium danger into Big Band. Because you can do that. Of course, with heavy characters, it's not often the case that that'll work. I'll kill them with Big Band, because that would be an easy example of this. I know what XD1 to run under me, you stupid fat idiot. There we go. Stuff. Where's the thing? Get over that way! Oh, god damn it. I just want that assist. Thank you. It's not gonna work with heavy assist, but it's a thing. I mean, if you do the light one, that will not work with that because that's teamwork is stupid. With heavy characters, you can just do standing hard punch in the Big Band. But the idea is you don't want to do that anyway because that's not max damage. It's an option you have if you don't have Philia on. This is kind of getting annoying. I want that. And you can do stuff like that to end your combo. Of course, you can end with standing hard punch into me, a danger super. What was I gonna say else about this? Because the thing with this is that you don't really... The problem with Robo-Fortune is that you can't do launcher, air combo, whatever, and land in super because the super's really slow. So that you just want to do a ground string into stuff. And you can do that with OTG, that works just fine. Like if you get steady heavy punch and heavy danger on a ground confirm, that's cool because you have your OTG and stuff like that. But if you did an air throw reset, you don't have that. So you want something to salvage the situation, and like add a super on top of it. So you can do stuff like that. That's about the end of my notes for Robo Fortune Point. Okay. Hey Aquanine in chat. Buy this game, dude. It's like $10 on Steam or whatever. It's like super cheap, and the DLC is like $15 with like 5 characters and just a ton of other stuff. Like there's like voice story mode and like challenges and stuff like that. I didn't buy it because I don't care much for this game anymore. But like if I played it, like seriously, I would spend that money to give, you know, because it's a cool game. Let's actually go to Philia Point now and. Oh whoa. Pew pew. Let's pick Magnetar Man because Magnetar Man is cool. I want that one. And these can be this character, that's cool. Philia, what did I write about this? Other point useful. Other point should have a comma in here because I'm an idiot. It doesn't. Other point, comma. Useful in matchups where HP is invaluable or as counter call, e.g. matchups with armored assists, because, let me say that, it's multi-hit and it comes out behind you. I can even show that with points. Training options, I want hitbox advanced. And you can see that right here, the point for Robo-Fortune. You can't see my mouse because it's kind of annoying. But the point for Robo-Fortune shows up before the point of Philia, like behind Philia's point. So the assist actually shows up behind you. And of course you can make this even better by like actually dashing in front of it. So it's kind of like a Virgil and Doom thing, where Doom comes out behind Virgil and Virgil can decide to just dash and then do whatever Virgil thinks he does. to action. And that, and I'll like set it up so that you don't see the stupid hitboxes anymore. Yes. Okay, what else? Useful in matchups where getting me to the point ASAP is imperative. Robo-Fortune doesn't really have the greatest mix-ups, so it's kind of annoying to, like, you can't really do, like, mix-up, like, you can't really do, I gotta hit mix-up, 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 and you're dead. You can't really do that. Her mix-up is a lot slower, it's not as great. Philia, on the other hand, is a mix-up machine. I don't consider that, whatever. I'm not gonna embarrass myself right now. But she has like tons of mix-ups, tons of resets. If you watch any high-level Philia, you can see that she just, when she hits you, she like you usually just die. So that's kind of the point of the character. See, that's why you kind of just have that. That's kind of the character's like why she's there. And I'm just gonna blow my nose real quick, and I'm gonna mute this. There we go. That was terrible. My nose is really frustrating, and it's kind of cold in the morning. But yeah, you can do stuff like that. Like you can just like you get a hit with Philia, and you can be like mix up, and you're dead. Especially because Robo-Fortune's level 1 deities do a fairly chunky amount of damage. Let me do a combo just to show. And it's going to be incredibly hard because my hands are cold right now. And this is not something I've practiced a whole lot. Oh god, I'm done with myself right now. You can do that into Beam Super, which is like it was 8.9k before, and you added like 8.9, 9.9. You added like something like 1.2ish. I can't do math right now, but it's a fairly sizable chunk. And you know, you like mix up, and DSC Beam, hella damage. Or you can combo to Magnet, whichever one you want. I personally think Magnet is better as a DSC because it only does one hit, and it's better for damage scaling purposes. It actually does less damage, but it's better overall because it doesn't give extra meter. Really useful for that, and it gives like decent things, just don't worry about it. Things with this team that are really, really good is... You don't know what side it's gonna hit on. You have no idea what side it's gonna hit on. You have no idea what side this is gonna hit on. I've hit this on people who are like actually really good at blocking resets, and they've told me this is basically 50-50. You can after the crouching medium punch, what you wanna do is you wanna crouching medium kick, medium punch, and immediately call hair beam. And once you do that, you wanna do crouching medium kick, crouching heavy kick. The timing in which you do the crouching heavy kick, and if you cancel it with the fake, the Korsuka forward kick. That makes it incredibly, incredibly, incredibly difficult to block. The problem is that you're starting it off in assist, so you can't really do anything. Like, you can't loop back into this. That's kind of annoying. But, let me show a simple conversion of this that you can use to immediately get another, assist back or something like that. I'm bad at this. I forgot what the combo was. Yeah, I remember what it was. Ah, my hands. Kinda cold. And then you can do that, and that's the standard reset that Philia does into another left, right, high, low, blah, 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 whatever. Burst break, stupid thing, whatever Philia does. So you can immediately go into another reset. You can also do like. I actually don't know if that works off this setup. Let me try to think of something quick. You can do some stuff with it. I mean, like, if you want to look into conversions, you can look that up on your own. Oh yeah, another thing I forgot to mention. Useful in the matches where Robo-Fortune can zone well because the opponent can occupy the airspace better, like Valentine and Painwheel. Oh yeah, Valentine and Painwheel are kind of annoying for Robo-Fortune on point, in my opinion. I don't think it's a great matchup. I think it's decent. I mean, it's a dealable matchup, but it's... If you pick, like, Philia and H-Beam, it's a lot more manageable than it ever would be, like, with the Robo-Fortune point. Because you have H-Beam as an assist, that makes them not fly in this, the zone that I'm covering with Steady Hard Punch. Like, I can't show it with my mouse because this is stupid. But, like, you know where, like, you see the ice cream? Like, that ice cream that I'm, like, kind of pointing at? They're really good at just being at that area and just doing stuff that Philia has, like Robo-Fortune is kind of a tough time dealing with. I mean, she has some, but it's not, like, super great. If you have H-Beam, it kind of makes it so that there's a carpet of sorts that they have to land on, that you can make them land on. And with proper spacing and everything, you can turn that, so that they're above you, you can turn that situation into an advantageous situation for yourself. It's really useful. That's that. So max damage corner throw with Robo-Fortune. Let's actually just go to the corner. It's a good move. With Philia, the easy corner combo everyone does it's whatever. But that combo, that requires the assist, that requires what I'm gonna say. That requires OTG after the hairball. You won't have that after the throw. So instead of doing just the hairball, you can do hairball plus assist. Not that assist, that assist. Oh, that's gonna suck. You can do medium hairball plus assist. It's less damage overall, but it's better than like dropping the combo altogether because you don't have OTG. That concept, hairball plus beam, that also has a lot more functions. I think I have a video on my YouTube channel that's like some stupid name, I can't remember what the name it was, but it was like some combo big bang comes up as in the front as a shield, stuff like that, and then you use hairball beam and then you do another hairball and you get the corner and stuff like that. It's kind of cool. I'll link it in the description when I put this up on YouTube. But it's useful. That tech is really useful, and I can show that happening mid screen actually. Yeah, that's it up. You can do stuff like that. Like you can use it to confirm. The thing with heavy is that, one, you can't do it with this team order because this game is stupid, but if you set that up properly, there we go, that's how you do it. It's do I have that? Yeah, I do. I have that. It's a lot harder with hard because, one, they go away, so it's only really useful in the corner. Like, the hard hairball takes a lot more time to finish than, like, the medium or the light ones do. So, it's a lot harder to do mid-screen. In the corner, it can work. So, if you have that team order set up that way, which you will if you're playing, like, Robo, Philia, Big Ben, and you DHC 2 Philia, you can use that heavy one in the corner for some extra damage. Corner combo to RF raw tag. Did I write this down? I totally did. Oh, I do paired. Corner combo to. Okay. Let me put them in the corner real quick. I like this stage. You can do stuff like that to tag to Iron Man. I messed that up, didn't I? You can tag to Robo-Fortune that way in the corner. It leads to a lot more damage. Let me show the optimal corner combo. I'm gonna drop this all the time because I'm dumb. Oh god, whatever. Like, you see that route, right? It, like, I can show the one with Philia, Robo-Fortune, and let's see how much damage this does. It says backdash before strength. I'm gonna try doing that. That's not what I want. You want the crouching hard punch to be in the air, so you get the air crouching hard punch, which is a lot better for combos. And then you can combo off of it. And you can tag off of it. I'm gonna drop this a lot more. You know what, let me shirt on a heavy character just to make it easy. Oh god, I have Bella. This doesn't work on Bella because Bella is stupid. Hey, it worked. No, it's the Ender. Okay, cool. Do I have that? Yeah. Let me show that. Oh. You don't want the tag OTG because, of course, you can't combo off it. Oh my god. kind of getting mad, I guess. I used to be able to do it. This should do it. Today's not a good day to do combos, is it? God damn it! I'm trying to show a stupid combo, if that's so hard. God damn it! Why did I pick Bella for this? Oh my god. There we go. Finally! And that's like a lot more than you would get off of just Philia. And I'm not gonna show the Philia combo. Because it would take me forever. It's already been an hour and I just really don't want to spend this much time on this. But of course if you get counter hits you can make this a lot more damage. I'll write down what I need to put in the description. Because I'll forget it. Because I have amazing memory. My memory is as good as my execution is on this day. I need to put in the combo. I need to put FI. And then put the tag combo. Extensions. I need that. Do note that the mid-screen beam left-right doesn't work on double and big band. On double, there's some stuff where, I think, what I write down. You can crush medium punch called Robo-Fortune instead of medium kick, dash twice, then hard punch versus back dash down hard punch. So it's like a left-right with just hard punch and stuff like that. It's that one you can use to set up more stuff. Like, I mean, you can just restand and do it all over again because it's cool. On BB, I couldn't find anything regarding that because the I just couldn't find anything that was as good as what the left right is. So there's that. Throw to RF raw tag. Okay, let me try this. This is not gonna work, huh? Oh yeah, this is light only. I forgot about that. Hey. Okay, this is gonna be great. You can do stuff like that. There's a conversion. What conversion did I write? Oh, you can even wait. Okay, staying medium. Okay, I can show the tag too as well. Yeah, of course, this is lights only. Doesn't work on bellow or anything like that. And you still have to time the dragon punch kind of correctly. Combo into raw attack from that as well. Or can you? This is stupid. This is not working, and I don't know why. I have to slip through. Oh, I saw something weird happen. Never mind. I don't think that works in the tag. I don't know why I roughed that thing. Might work on some other kick or some stupid thing like that. I don't remember. Ignore that completely then, I suppose. I mean, the non-ODG conversion. At least for swag, anyway. Just keep that. Why can I not do this? Where is the SS? There we go. I mean, you can keep that, but like, don't actually try the raw tag, because I've shown you the raw tag doesn't really work, because I don't know why I put that there. I'm dumb. There must be some way to make it work, but I don't remember it right now. It's double snap to Big Bad. I don't remember how we wrote it down. Corner combo to Big Band tag. Oh, you can OTG tag, and I believe you're plus after that. It's plus 10, so yeah, you're plus after that. So, I mean, you don't get a combo because you OTG the tag, but you get a mix-up and a corner tech J situation like that, which can be useful. It's mostly useful for the fact that, I mean, it's not like you don't really want a raw tag. Outside of the Robo-Fortune thing, the Robo-Fortune thing does a lot more damage than just doing a Filia corner combo, because Filia's damage is not that great. The thing that the Big Band tag helps with is that it allows Filia and Robo-Fortune to kind of regen their life while Big Band is doing Big Band corner things. Big Band's corner matchup is actually really good and leads to a lot of damage. But if your Filia is really low on life and your Robo-Fortune is really low on life, you don't want either of them out, and you want them to both regen as much of their life as possible, you can get Big Band out and like get Big Band to kind of do some of his things while he kind of he helps regenerate Filia and Robo-Fortune's life. And it's not like you really want a DHC with Big Band, because Big Band by himself does a lot of damage. So you won't often need to do that to kill. So you can just be like, oh, I'll just do like a silly little reset more, and just kill them with stuff, things, I don't know. do know that the DP into beam, it works better with heavy, steady heavy punch assist with Robo-Fortune, because then it works on a lot more characters, and because steady heavy punch is a lot more fast, is a lot faster and has a little bit more hit stun, you can easily combo off of it easier. That's about it for Philia. There might be some other stuff I have found, but I can't be bothered remembering it. Let's just have Big Band out. What did I say about Big Band? Ideally, he should never come out to play because the assist is too valuable, but if you get hit, he might be snapped in or might have to come in as anchor. Or your other two characters might be low on life and you need the red life, is what I just said. Like, why would you have BB out? It's for that reason. Big Band... There we go. Usually the Big Band combo most people do. And two things, it uses up your OTG at the start with the medium punch brass. You can make it so that it doesn't spend OTG with, I think... I think it did have a heavy as well, I don't remember. I didn't know why I hit that. You can do something like that for a healthy chunk of damage and not that much OTG, not that much undizzy, and keeping the corner. Really useful. I want to say this doesn't work on heavy characters? I don't remember for sure. I'm dumb, it works. It works on everybody. It might be that the beam stuff doesn't work on every character. I know some of it doesn't work on every character. Would it be like Valentine or something like that? I remember like trying it on one character, but it just like didn't work. That was kind of annoying. Or like it ate up OTG, something like that. Let's pick that one, and let's pick that one. I think it was like... It was some weird character that I remember, distinctly remember. I was like, I'm gonna get hella damage on this, but then I just dropped because like, what the hell? It might be one of these three characters, I don't remember for sure. I'm sorry about that. It was like a long time ago. Alright, where's your dad assist? Where's your dad assist? Yeah, like, there you go! That's the one I was trying. It doesn't work on Valentine for some reason. I think you can do that instead, then. And it still works, but you don't get the standing hard kick at the start, which is like you see, it's like 1200 damage. It's kind of a lot, so missing out of that is kind of annoying. But I mean, you can also just do medium brass. But of course, that is again not as much damage. So, okay, 2-2. Double snap tech to Robo-Fortune. I have that in the video. Oh yeah, Philia can also double snap tech to Robo-Fortune. But I have that in the video. I will also link that one in the description. If you're playing a Robo-Fortune team of any kind, you need to know that conversion. It's really, really, really useful to get heads and stuff like that. Narf double snap head. I'll link that in the description. What else am I going to talk about? to double snap attack to Robo-Fortune, double snap attack to failure. Okay. Let's. Let's get these stupid people to call their stupid assists. I don't even start, never mind. Whoops. Huh. You can see that works. Go away. On this is lights only. Oh god, get another. Goddamn. Okay, sorry. On mediums and heavies, you need to do 2 standing medium kicks before you do the standing hard kick, so you can get the standing hard kick to uncombo. If you understand what that means, uncombo is basically like you're doing a combo, but then you're dropping the combo, but you're still continuing the combo because it's on double snap or whatever. That makes like no sense, but I hope you understand. What the hell is that? Oh, it's the squiggly. Oh, I don't know that. And the shadow's darker. That's just leaving as well. Whatever. That's that. Mid combo tag to fill you. Corner only. Okay, I'll choose. Okay. I'll show the tag to fill you. I'll actually get like a character in. Of course, you want to preserve OTG, which is kind of the point of me doing the assist. So you can combo off the OTG with the tag and stuff like that. That's not what I wanted. Whoops. Yeah, I just said it slow. I was afraid it just didn't actually combo. Ah, oh, God, a second combo. God damn it. Why is that not working? Thank you. god damn it. I forgot what the extra combo was. Why is that actually not working, guy? I'm actually not gonna use them temper. Okay. Hush now. Or it might be that I'm doing the wrong combo. Again. Step off, square. Oh, yeah. I can just show the easy combo instead and try to land that. You can do something like that. That's about it for that. And mid combo tag to RF. That's the last thing I want to show. This video has gone far too long for me just dropping all sorts of combos. I really apologize. If I actually had done like actual editing, I could have like make this like 21 minutes with like 7 minutes each at most for most characters. But you know, whatever. I don't want to bother with editing this. A mid combo tag to Robo-Fortune. Okay. Oh yeah. Look at that TV. Oh my god. Look at this TV reset. Ha. Actually set up so it makes it easier for me. Oh yeah, I probably need to delay it a lot. Your move. Speaking of stuff, I'll actually shut the full combo. Probably not good there. Yeah, stuff like that. There you go. Finally learned that. That's a fair amount of damage. And that's about it as far as my notes go, actually. Oh, it's... there's some other stuff. Philia... dash... punch. Damn. Oh yeah. Combo using Robo-Fortune, using Big Band. There's the alternate team with the alternate assists. If you have the what I want to call the Wolverine team, which is more like, which is like Philly, Robo-Fortune, Big Band, dash, Stunning Hard Punch, Heavy Brass, you can use like Brass at the start of your confirms to do a lot of damage, or you can use let's wait up thing. You can use, basically you just use Big Band to do a lot of damage, or you can use the Dragon Punch plus the DP plus Robo-Fortune thing to for swag purposes. So it's always cool. Swag is always necessary. For RF, you use the mid screen using DB. I think someone put it out. I can't remember. I didn't write it down because I'm dumb. What else? Oh yeah, because if you're picking that team, you don't get to do the... You can do the tag combo. The tag combo is really useful to keep Philly alive as much as possible. In the corner, the that stuff. Not, I mean, not this like kicker exactly, but like... like stuff like that that you do after the launch or whatever that I kept dropping a lot of times. That's still useful, but you don't have the hairball assist because you have dash. So you can't do the extension as easily. So you have to like make some modifications to it. You don't do the special. You just do like taking medium punch charge, and link standing light punch into ender. That's what you do. What was I gonna say? The point of the Philia Robo-Fortune Big Band, the dash standing up and six brass is to keep Philia alive as long as possible, and as long as Philia is alive, you have some way of getting in, because you have ton of armor, you have armor from far away that you can use to kind of just be like, you know, screw you, I'm just gonna get in, just drop me if you can. And up close, you can use the armored standing heart punch assist as a lockdown and armor. So if they try to mash out somehow, they can't do that. They get hit by the armor, and then you can come off of it. That's kind of the point of the team. It's a lot more rushdown, and it's not as well rounded. Like if Philia dies in that team, the team's kind of in a pickle. But the point is to keep Philia alive as long as possible, and especially if you get Robo-Fortune in and they're dead in the corner. Robo-Fortune's corner set play using like air throw or the crouching leg kick confirm or just crouching leg kick or like throw, because you can combo off the turn corner. That's kind of where like Robo-Fortune can do stuff and Philia can get her life back. Unfortunately, there is no way to tag from Robo-Fortune to Philia unless your opponent is Big Band. I'll show that conversion as well because it's kind of cool. It requires RTG. I mean, the combo afterwards requires RTG, of course, because that's how Philia tag works. But, actually, I'll just pick two characters. And I will not pick any colors. And I'll pick Big Band and character doesn't matter. The point of that is to, I mean, it only works on Big Band because Big Band's so wide. And I think it only supposed to work on, like, crouching Big Band. You can do stuff like that. You need a combo for that? Oh yeah, I know how to combo for that. Huh? There you go. You just need a certain amount of hits to push you away as far as possible to get like the proper positioning, whatever. What else about this team? The raw tech stuff is mainly useful to keep Philia alive, but I already said that. Dash assist. Dash assist is not. It's not a neutral game assist, and it's not a combo assist, or it's not a combo extender assist of any kind. Unless you can find some swag combos with it, I have no idea how to do that. The point of having dash assist is dash alpha counter. And it's a dash alpha counter whenever, like, you have your Robo-Fortune set play going, but then you mess up, right? You don't want to mess up. But if, say you messed up somehow, it just happens, you know, it's life. You mess up in life. You mess up in life and you pick those games. But if you mess up, dash AC is a really, really safe way that really can't be baited in any fashion if you do it right. I mean, you can just, you know, drop your combo or whatever, drop your block string and get them to, like, try to alpha counter the next hit, but the dash will come out or whatever. You can bait it that way. But as long as you made, like, any normal, like, the normal has made any sort the normal has made any sort of contact, you can't really get anything, you know, like, you can't really use anything to punish Philia for doing the alpha counter. So it's a completely safe alpha counter if you want to attempt it. Whatever, nothing else about that. So that's primarily its main use. So, like, any time you get Philia out, but the other characters get in the pickle, Philia can be like, you know, just let me in again. And Philia has a good defense, especially on the ground, with, like, Dragon Punch into Gregor. So if anyone's, like, really want to rush you down after the Alpha Gunner as well, you can just uppercut. Or if they don't want to uppercut, then you can, like, if they're, like, baiting your Heart Punch or whatever, then you can just, like, then you can just be a jerk and square dash jump hard kick cross up on them, because why not? If they're baiting your DP that way. just to be a jerk. Well, that's about it, actually. Like, that's all the tech I know with this team. I mean, of course, there's, like, individual character tech, like how incomings work and stuff like that. I'm not going to go into that. You can find plenty of resources. You can find it on Skullheart. I have the Robo-Fortune Compendium on Skullheart. That goes into that a little bit more detail. There is also the Philia Compendium, I believe. It's being made. There's a Big Bang Compendium that's already made. That's really good. The Philia Compendium is also there. That's also really good. Skullheart.com is where you want to go for individual character stuff. But if you're looking for just the team specifics and the team tech, that's probably it. That's about as much as I could find during the time I was playing this game. Of course, if you want to pick this up, all the best. I wish you all the best. And what was I gonna say? It's really useful. This team is really good. This team is a really unorthodox team in the sense that the way most people pick most teams is that they just look for one configuration, and they just like stick with that. But the thing with this team is that you can really sort of pick a bunch of different assists and create almost completely different teams. Like I'll go back and just show you. Wrong color. Color is very important. That versus like, I don't know what colors to pick. I guess that one. These two teams, the one on the left and the one on the right, they might have the same characters, but they don't have the same assist, and they play very, very, very differently. So it's like, if you learn the characters and you learn this tech, which is, admittedly, I'm gonna say not the best tech out there. I mean, of course, you can improve on it in a bunch of different ways. Like, there's so much variance that you can get out of this one team, that it's really, really, it's a very different, it doesn't really happen most often in many team games. Most team games kind of just, the character just kind of just plays one. The characters kind of just play one way because the player wants to optimize for one particular game plan, which is fine. But this way is extremely useful to kind of just be like, you thought I'm just gonna play this team, but I can just kind of vary my assist and my team order, and all of a sudden I'm playing a different game. Which I think in some I think the tournament rules for this game are that if the opponent loses and changes characters, he can change assists. I might be wrong. I'm probably wrong on that. But he can definitely change team order. He can definitely change team order. So you can, use that to kind of mess around and change, how you went. If your opponent counterpicks with, a Valentine team or whatever, and you have, this team, you can just, switch to Felia. And all of a sudden, you have a completely different game plan going in because of that one team order change. Not necessarily even just the assist. So that's extremely, extremely useful to have in a team. That amount of variability, I don't know if that's really a word, variance in game plans, that's extremely useful to have. And many teams don't really have that. And if you want to pick up this team, good luck. I hope you use this tech. I hope you find better tech than this. Because some of it is kind of not that great, especially the kamikaze into the tech chase or whatever. It's not super great, but you can use it to protect yourself in case of an DP or whatever. What else was I gonna say? That's about it, actually. I don't really have much else. I mean, I could show. I could show once. Nah, actually, I'm not gonna bother with that. I mean, there's some throws that, if you do throw into assist, unless you can attack Philia for this. If they're incoming, you call H-beam and then you throw them as they're coming in. You can use stuff like that to incoming mix-ups and stuff like that. And if they end up picking the throw, they have to block beam, so you get one more mix-up opportunity. I mean, that's there's stuff like that. That's about it, actually, as far as I can think with the scene. So, if you watch this video for this long, I sincerely appreciate your patience. Sorry I dropped all my combos. I just am incredibly rusty with this game, and it's, like, really cold, so my hands are really cold. And I couldn't really do anything. So, that's about it. And I don't know if I'll ever play this game again, honestly. It's kind of sad, because the scene is mostly dead. And the people who do play, oh, I can't get a good connection with them because my internet is terrible with them for some reason. That's about it. I can't really think of anything else. Why is this really fun crashing for me? Damn, I'm tired though. I'm probably gonna go to sleep again, something like that. But again, yeah, just thanks for watching, guys. And I'll be sure to put this stuff in the description as soon as the video is exported. And that's it.